You all assembled here to wage a war against one of the crucial evils of modern society. This is not a new command. The legacy for the past several millennia, it has been relentlessly fought by innumerable people of various centuries. Instances of evil, battle between evil and virtues, success and re-entry of evil, rescheduling of the fight, all these four things are inescapable zones of global function. These things will continue to exist till the complete annihilation of the global itself. So we are in a phase of transition of preventing the re-entry of evil and to fortify the society with the essential morals which are indispensable for the harmonious functioning of the society. And whenever we are taking a single evil, it does not mean that there are no other evils. Each and every evil has its own brotherhood and connectivity with other things. And alcoholism, I want to say that it is a genocide. Just as in war, thousands of people are killed. Just as in deluge, dissolution and disaster, thousands of people are killed. It is also alcoholism is also killing the people. It is not only killing the people. It is killing the valuable labor of people for contributing for the society and for the family. It is killing the precious time and putting them in intoxication, which deals with the lethargic nature, sleepiness, hypnotism and various other things. It also kills the efficiency of people and integrity between the society and its members. It also reduces the lifespan of the people. And also, it aims at health hazards. So we should understand that alcoholism should be considered as a campaign against a silent but a smart way of genocide that is happening to society, which is killing the labor, health, integrity, harmony, efficiency and lifespan. We should also understand that when we say alcoholism, it does not mean that it is alcoholism alone. There are three things I want to say about alcoholism. One is equivalence. Second is fragmentation. And the third thing is alternatives. What is equivalence? There are a lot of people who won't drink at all, but whose behavior either equals or excels even the drunkards. So it is the characteristic affinity of somebody's behavior, which is not any alcohol, because they are having that inbuilt provision of alcoholic secretion, which do not require any other external stimulus. So there are second thing is known as alternatives, which we call like the drug addiction and various other mispractices and malpractices of the society. They are also equally having the present relation with alcoholism. Third thing is fragmentation. Even though some things are not so cruel as what we call alcoholism, they have fragmented efficacy to deal with what the alcoholic influence is. For example, I want to say apathy itself is the fragmental portion of what alcoholism is, but those things are excusable, those things are tolerable, those things are adjustable, minimizable. So we are taking into something which is intolerable, which is reaching the surmounting the parallel peak of intolerability and crucialism that we are just now taking into account. So alcoholism is a representative of everything that nullifies human rational, human coordination to think and act with the sanity and sensibility of what is happening in the society. So alcoholism does not deal with the source of intoxication. It deals with act of intoxication. It deals with the impact of intoxication, where we lose our balance of emotional standard, where we lose our intellect, where we lose our responsibility towards the society. So alcoholism is a totalitarian name out of which any other beverage that is entering there, it is only a portion of it. So being against alcoholism is not only against the beverage of alcoholism, but the impact of alcoholism which makes the person to lose their morale, to lose their responsibility, to lose their efficacy and principal way of living. So it is a totalitarian or common perception of what we call alcoholism, number one. And to bring the same thing with the limited time, I want to just run fast and finish this thing. Just some few points which may be the source of information and inspiration for proceeding this holy journey or crusade in a very infallibly successful manner in the future. It has to be taken in most of the parts of India and it is also a global message we know that. Number one, whenever we come to the psychology of or psychology of alcoholism, whether it is external or internal, you should understand there are two principal energies. One is the survival or supporting energy, second is the stimulating energy. They are known as stimulants. You know, the human beings, they get food, water and respiration and they survive. Apart from that, there is some sort of stimulation. Stimulation comes from motivation, inspiration from people, care from parents and other relatives and good personalities, and also it is nourished by a person's inner zeal and commitment. This is the natural stimulant that exists between all of these people. Whenever there is absence of this stimuli, whenever there is a deficit, whenever there is non-compatibility or aversion that is there inside the human mind due to configurative divide or disability, then human being goes for external stimuli apart from this factor. Whatever alcohol gives, that is given by, that is positively supplemented by paternal care, scholarly advice, preceptorial guidance, all of these positive factors are giving you essential manifestations in the form of care, concern, love, affection and various other things. Whenever there is either non-availability of external resources or inner resources so that we can receive all of these things, then the human mind goes for seeking some other external stimuli. Unless this foundation is understood by the society, alcoholism cannot be fully controlled at all, it cannot be approved at all. Number one, entering stimuli. Entering means it is time-oriented, it is temporary. Second thing is in present, it has no effect at all, but due to the extreme bit of frustration we used to resolve something based on self-deception, we are not getting any benefit, but we assume that we get some benefit. We are getting adversity, but we feel that we are getting solace or comfort. So this type of pseudo-hallucination that we hallucinated itself is pseudo. Pseudo-hallucination means that is double and double the hallucination that we get due to self-deception. Then due to these various things, we go for certain fatal illegal agencies or even some of the good agencies are there. Fraternal agencies and fatal agencies used to say in psychology. Whenever you go for certain things, that is that you should understand human mind. Human mind is full of blanks. We have to fill up the blanks. When they are happy, they have to celebrate it. When they are in distress, there should be a solace and embrace. And whenever they are in need of doing some work, they should be having some instigation. Then all of these blanks are not well filled. They will be ill-filled naturally. They will be ill-filled naturally. So, a positive direction towards number one, work, towards relations and love-making, towards commitment, towards intellectual exercises like research, towards prayer and service to the society. If they are not properly filled in the band, whenever they are in solitude, whenever they are in distress, whenever they are happy, it knows no reason. They are happy, they are sad, they are alone, they are with people. Everything has its own reason for alcoholism. Why you are drinking, I am alone. Why you are drinking, I am with my friends. Why you are drinking, I am happy. Why you are drinking, you are sad. So for all reasons, there is a false justification to go into alcoholism. So they should be filled with their well-filling agents instead of ill-filling agents. Unless this type of campaign is spiritually taken, educationally imparted, inherited from the parents, very difficult to conduct such campaigns in the wrong way. It is started in the proper way. This is a small iteration what we want to do. And second thing is, this type of stimuli, apart from getting from relation, from God, from parents, from social ideal models, we should get that. As it is not obtainable, we are resorting to the filthiest elements known as commodities. Certain commodities are as per Shastra, they are totally prohibited, you should not take it. Second thing is state of the commodity, like grapes are there, just Shastra says that it is permissible, but the state of a stale nature of intoxicants that are situated inside the grape in the form of wine, that is prohibited. That is state prohibition. Third is quantity prohibition. Somebody told that there is only a quantity problem, you can take a limited quantity. No, it is not permissible at all. Because that type of self-restraint to limit the quantity is not available to all people. There are four problems regarding the spiritual sciences. One is gradual drift. You start with a small quantity, gradually you will be getting into alcoholic development program and it will become a big quantity. Second thing is company drift. If you join with the drunkards, it may be induced more. Circumstantial quality, if you are habitually a limited drunkard, then gradually when you are pressurized by circumstances, it may go more. Fourth thing is very dangerous, anuvartana. Anybody having limited drinking in this birth, according to transmigration theory of Hinduism, will continue in the circumstances to become a great drunkard in the future. So taking even a droplet of these things on any circumstances, whether on limitations or unlimited or circumstances, no justification should be made as per the Shastras, as per the common consensus of the universal ethicism and global civilization. So this we should understand, it is very much remarkably placed by our Shastra. The third thing is, what is alcohol? You know, ethanol is what we call alcohol. The Shastra says that it is pratishiddha. Each and every element has the best thing and also the worst thing. Alcohol is nothing but the extraction of the worst thing, processing of the worst thing that should be totally condemned at all. The excreta of each and every creation, it is meant for its own preservation. It is not meant for extraction, processing and consumption by other people. So it is like excreta, it cannot be consumed at all. It is totally against the central nervous system's function. It is a depressant of central nervous system. Moreover, it does not go through the digestion system. It is directly absorbed by the blood. And blood concentration of alcohol is now red as a very dangerous symbol for the existence of the cardiac system as well as the circulatory system. The third thing is, as all cell membranes are easily permeable with mucous chambers and eyes, it is easily penetrated inside, resulting in blurred vision, confusion, lack of coordination of thinking and proper memory. It deals with also asphyxiation. It also deals with enlargement of heart and various other problems which are physical in nature. So we should understand these things are very much common and also known to the drunkards more than the other people who are maintaining the campaign. So we should understand that we have to work. It is not in bringing awareness about what are the effects of alcohol. It is to create the moral fortitude or the ethical courage in the people by a spiritual transmission so that they can understand what they know already. It is what we have to do in this campaign, not by introducing other things which are already published. They experience more ill effects than what the campaign makers are doing. We don't know the experience. They are more knowledgeable than us for the reason that they are experiencing what we are just talking. So they are greater than that. What we need is to install a moral courage inside them. There are a lot of excuses for this alcoholism. They used to say that it is nirupana in Shastras. I'll just read them and read. One is the status or pride. Instead of thinking it as a guilt and shame, before we used it, it was a matter, even before decades. Now it is a pride symbol. Even domestic parties between family members, then public parties and festivals, it is a must, it has become a must. So it is a pride symbol. And second thing is taste. You know that whenever we see an insect in our food, we immediately throw not only the insect but also the food. But there are certain creatures like lizards for whom the insect itself is the food. So it is a taste by configuration, like that is the worst taste in the world, and it could be relished only because of the poor configuration when the person gets a real mastery over his own conscience and proper education and realization. He feels that whatever he did earlier is filthy. We want to bring realization. All the other things like control, government policies, everything is intervention. We don't negate them. Simultaneously, perennial and permanent source should be brought only by realization. So that's why they say taste is also not the problem. The third thing I have already told about company and association needs to do. And there is a myth in the society that alcohol is a booster, a reliever and inducer. Somebody told great people, great thinkers, scientists and great artists and musicians, they are drunkards. It is not like that, they belong to a special category. In spite of that intoxified nature, they used to perform with precision, which cannot be possible by all people, so it is a wrong imitation. And second thing, even those people, they are affected physically by their wrong habits. The third thing, we have to go for alternative inference. If they have not taken that liquor, have taken some other positive thing, they would have excelled more. This is the real system of inference. So, false justification or wrong matching of things, considering that it is a booster of all of the person's expertise and dexterity, is a myth. Second thing is, reliever of stress and pain, no, it induces more. The third thing is, it is also a stimulator of sleep or something. There is a research known as hypnoalcoholics. What is the impact of alcoholism on sleep? Does it produce sleep? Does it produce anti-analgesic nature like painlessness? No, it is not that. Everything is a speculation, a wrong calculation. It appears to be so and it gives irretrievable loss in the future. That's what they have researched. So we should also understand that there is no medical quality is critical. Naturally, inbuilt alcohol is there inside the body, also inside various other acidic contents in the creation of God, which are natural preservatives. The external extraction, processing, and consuming liquor or alcohol as a separate entity can never act as a medical product, can also act as an anti-medical product, as a fatal drug. It cannot give any benefit at all. The final thing is religious justification. A lot of people say that religion says about sacrifice of
was very much researched in Hinduism also. We should understand that each and every religion teaches innumerable things. Forgetting everything, why you are really sincerely covering this alone? And that also, that many of us are entirely different and anti-religion, and those things, those qualitative elements are not available now. You are not so good to know. So even religious justification for all of these things cannot be permitted. Final thing is very interesting, they say that standard and quality. There are some quality dreams which are not harmful. It is pure exploitation of poor people. Poor people cannot afford to purchase all of these things. As they are having more tension and stress, they will go for more drinking. So they have to incur two expenditure. One is purchasing more drinks and drinking them. Second is if they are getting into any illness, the treatment, medical expenditure is more. So this type of this thing, it creates exploitation of the poor people who cannot afford for the high-end drinks. So anyway, there is no justification for all of these things, but any quality and standard in the society. It gives the first sin, what we call as intellectual decoordination. Your ability to think, execute and plan will be totally reduced and it will be permeated into the non-contextual zones. What is that? Somebody told that if I am drinking, I cannot think and coordinate. So after that I can coordinate. This is not correct because whenever you drink, the impact of your alcoholism that extends also to your non-alcoholic zones of life and then it heavily infects your coordination to think and execute. So a person who is drinking, even while he has not drunk, he will have the same impact, similar impact and sophisticated impact of decoordination or de-alignment of his ability to think, plan and execute. So it is not justifiable at all. The second thing is physically nervous debilitation and premature death is there. That is also there. In mind, the person is made more brutal. Already if the person is brutal, he is made more brutal. That is known as what we call primary nature. There are two things, one is primary nature, second is silent nature. If a person is already a brutal person, a violent person, if he drinks, it becomes more. If your person has the brutality hidden inside because of fear, because of balancing, because of emotional control, who is withholding that violent nature, if he takes that alcohol, his withholding nature and emotional balance totally rules out and the person becomes violent. So non-violent person, inner violence is stimulated and a violent person's violent nature is intensified. So at any cost it should not be made so. Final thing is sin. Somebody tell me, what is the sin? There are three problems with alcohol. One is external damage. It spoils all of your connected people, associates and accompanies. Second is internal damage. It spoils your mind, your body and other things. Even if you say that I don't disturb anybody and I am here and healthy, it gives you the subtle corrosion of your spiritual ability, so it should not be taken. Somebody may say that, no, I am not feeling any unhealthy experience. I am here and healthy, still I am taking drinks for the past 4 decades. I am not disturbing, quarreling with anybody. If I take, I love people more. You can say that of certification. Even we say that alcohol is the seat of truth. When somebody drinks, then only they bring the real truth. So there are innumerable justifications, but they are not real. There are innumerable good days for that. So this is what we should understand, that what is the ill effect that we have to understand from this alcohol. In modern society, there is more solitude, there is no relation between the family people, there is more wrong company, there is more opportunities to be stressy, to be more frustrating. So here, new things come. Number one, innovation of new varieties, fusion of new varieties, more liberal marketing, and everything is raising the ugliest heads in the most cruel and clumsy form, that this is the worst thing of the world. What is the duty? What is the duty of the self? What is the duty of the parents? What is the duty of the government? Government has more duty. They have to do parallel action, number one. They have to prevent these things from being manufactured. They should be heavily taxed. They should be highly controlled and limited. They should be heavily licensed on various scrupulous and stipulated conditions. They should be minimized. And incentives should be given for people, those who are going away from that, and punishment should be severe for people, those who are violating the rules of this making, and all of these various things by means of the retributive and contributive systems of justice should be implemented. Proper prosecution and immediate punishment should be there, lot of incentives should be there, and simultaneously there should be training, awareness, rehabilitation and various issues. It should be a parallel governance, it should be there. But there must be training, awareness, rehabilitation and various issues. It should be a parallel governance. It should be that. But the present government has to face three major justification issues and 5 accusations. The first thing is silly accusation or justification. Second thing is false accusation.
The third thing is funny accusation or foolish accusation or justification. What is the justification? The first justification government says is, if we don't organize this, if we don't organize this by means of proper productivity, the stocking and the sales and other things, then there is possibility of a simultaneous shadow production agency where low quality, adulterated, toxic or venomous things will be produced and they will be circulated in the black market. So this thing is known as filthy justification. If we don't do this, if we don't organize this, already what to organize it? Something which is fatal and something is nonsense. And what is the principle of organizing something which is nonsense? When somebody says that they will organize something nonsense, it should be totally prohibited. So they say that it will come. If such things are coming into society, it is the duty of a masculine government to curb it with the iron chains. And they should not give the justification at all. And second thing is the justification of falsity. That should be some outlet to the people. If this is not provided, they will go for something worse. And immediately those who are drinking, they should not stop it. Because of various reasons. Nervous stability, various other confusion will be there, dangerous will be there. These are maybe most of the members of the society. It is not so that there is a strong will and strong replacement, strong training and proper means of rehabilitation by medical aid and mental aid. There are two things. One is meditative, second is medicative. If both of these unify together, immediately anybody can transform himself and transform others. It is actually a false system of justification that exists in the society. The funniest thing of justification in the society is the government is saying we are also conducting rehabilitation centers, we are also organizing awareness campaigns, we are giving statutory warning in each and everything. Okay? Wherever you are doing the alcohol services, the service is perfect. Wherever you are doing anti-alcoholic services, the services are perfectly. Do you pay equal attention to both of the things? You are not doing it like that. Those things are given in big letters and these things are given in small letters. Further, I want to suggest you this. Complete prohibition of alcohol is a motto, but you have to start with small peace agencies. What are they? Booklets ought to be published and distributed, not distributed separately like in these places. It should be compulsorily made to be distributed with each and every wine bottle in the government box. It should not be separately given. It should be immediately given with all of the last report, factual report with photos and various other medical statistics. It should be provided there. Second thing, adjacent agencies. It should be compulsory that each and every bar should have an adjacent counseling center. Third thing is inner counseling center. Each and every bar should have a desk for the counsel being appointed director. Fourth thing is very funny, it may not happen, if it happens, it's okay. Sub-placement. That should be a counseling center predominantly, and there should be a bar inside, and everybody has to pass through what is the counsel, then it is a bar. So if these things are not given, see, if you are doing something and you won't want to do that, you should go the vehemence in prohibition rather than in inhibition. Government is not doing that. You should do it properly. At least equally you should go the concern you are not doing. This is for namesake and that is for gamesake. And what is this rule? So we have to object this and we have to see how it is possible. Number one, there are a few accusations I have already listed and few more things that are more interesting. I have never heard about scarcity of arak or liquor. Water scarcity is there, milk scarcity is there, education poverty. Have anybody heard about the scarcity of alcohol? It is not there. Second thing is, it is more funny. Government says that it is going to utilize the funds received from this marketing for public welfare. By spoiling the public, if you get money and use it for public welfare, what type of game it is? Is it sane in nature? Can you just guess the sanity in this thing? There is nothing like that. Third thing, according to Shastras, the money that you receive from spoiling the people, corrupting their mentality, dismantling their domestic peace, integrity and welfare, that money is nothing but misery and misfortune in disguise that will invite lot of perils to the society. Lot of disasters to society, political instability, that is come from. Because the money itself is sinful, though it gives only painful experiences. How you can get gain instead of pain if the money is sinful in nature? And it is more clear that if the mother instead of milk, she is giving poison. Government is the mother. It should reform people and prevent them from doing such things. If it deforms the people and encourages them by creating policies and provisions and accessibilities, what is the role of this government? So it is not. So, and one more thing is, already violence is there in society. By creating these things with a competitive measure in money gaining, there is political gain, clashes, groupism, violence and everything happening during the wine shops.
innumerable things are being exasperated more. So these are all the accumulations in society.
So I want to conclude that we have to start few things. Number one is de-addiction by means of medications.
Minimization, we should see that they minimize slowly. Third, those who are fresh people, those who are going to be the would-be drunkards of the future, we should take a strong vote from them. Positive deviation or engagement should be given to the people so that it can be prevented. And fifth thing is spiritual substitutes should be there. Then indigenous substitution is there. There are a lot of people who are working for indigenous substitution of toddy instead of various other things which are not from the other countries. So there is a limitation, there is some indigenousness. It is not preferable, but comparatively these things are to be introduced to dismantle the empire of Arachism and alcoholism. So we should slowly go for various other things in the society also. And one more thing we are researching is that there is a herbal cigarette which gives the feeling of having smoked, but still it is not harmful. So it is a herbal substitute. Like that, there should be something alcohol substitute which is to be innovatively designed for the benefit. And one more thing is by education, by family plantation, by spiritual guidance, and by social aptitude and attitude, we should instill self-governing and counseling everything in each and every person so that he will never drink in his life at all. There is no need for drinking at all. So these eight limbs are very much essential for the society. We need skillful agents, orators or counselors, number one. Number two, we need professional doctors. The third person should be NGOs of the society, those who are very much committed for such programs. Fourth thing is media people, we should have media campaigns. Fifth thing is people like yoga, which is beyond religion, which is beyond any other specific problem, which is universal and all encompassing. It should be implemented. Yoga experts should also be there for teaching meditation and other things in society. We should have brand ambassadors. We are having for soap and other users things. We should have brand ambassadors for alcoholism also, top post people in various celebrities level, and we should see that it is being done. There is a research agency known as Global Alcohol Policy Alliance, for whom there is Indian Alcohol Policy Alliance, IAPA is there. They have done the research and given few points I want to quote, very interesting. Number one, in all the developed countries, drinking habits are decreasing. In developing countries like India, it is increasing. Number two, nudities, pancreatitis, heart enlargement, liver damage, poor memory, lack of coordination of mind, and various other perils have been reported more by alcoholism in the frequent centuries. Recent era, it is reported more. Number three, 62.5 million drunkards, dignified drunkards are there in India, as per report. And 80% of the people, they are going for hard liquor or alcohol, where the percentage of damage is more. We are thinking that we are taking high-end drinks or we are taking limited drinks, it is not that. 80% of the people consume hard alcohol, which is very, very pernicious to health as well as to the social integrity. Then the rate of growth of this noble deed is increasing 8% per year. 40% of the people only consume branded liquor, so 60% of the people are put in distress. They consume something and they are going to suffer, and they are suffering at all. And one more interesting report is in the year 1950-60, the people, those who are going for these drinks, they are between the age group of 23-36. Now 18-19 research report says that 19-45 is the age group who are going for drinking. So we can see a lot of youngsters, budding and blossoming youngsters and students holding bottles instead of their books. In various shops, you can see that daily you are seeing that. So that is also being improved. It is only because of the reason that 28,000 crores, that is the income that they are getting this thing, without minding what is that for the future of the children, future of their dynasty and future of the society. It is a big social disaster. Alcoholism is an economic disaster. It is a global active disaster. We should consider it instead of considering it as a misbehavior or a small bad habit. It is not so. It is a global thing. So they have given this report. In spite of this income, Mizoram, Manipal, Nagaland, and Gujarat, they are totally privatized this income. How they could run the government successfully like government like Gujarat? So we should create a public, positive, democratic protest and consensus to be presented so that it can be totally prevented. Signature campaign, public poll opinion, innumerable things are there. Moreover, they have also given one report which is very interesting. Due to this alcohol consumption in offices and schools and other working areas, absenteeism is more. Loss created by, we should note down, loss created by alcoholic accidentalism is 70,000 million rupees as per recent report. Then what is your income? Where is your income? Which is more, the loss or your income? So we should be so prudent instead of seeing something in the behind. We should see something beyond. If you see behind, you will see only income. If you see beyond, you will see the catastrophe that is coming to the society. Second thing is domestic violence, separation, absurdity in the families in various decision making, single parented homes, assault, and various other things that are happening. Third thing is social misbehavior and unrest. This is also happening due to this alcohol. Fourth thing is 3 to 45% of the household income is diverted for alcohol consumption. So the money that you are enjoying from alcohol is nothing but the money of food, money for medicine and money for education of the poorest people, which foolishly they have handed over to you, not intentionally. You exploited their innocence, temptation and craze. Is wrong. You have to teach them how to feel for the society and how to govern oneself. You should not exploit that. So this is the money of exploitation. And Kerala, there is a crown of the person you have taken the campaign. Kerala not only the kingdom of God and known for literacy, it is also known for alcohol literacy. It has been reported that it is one of the global leaders and it is having the highest per capita alcohol consumption of 8.3 liters per person. This is the status. The rice consumption is 2,880 crores, whereas alcohol consumption is 7,500 crores. Will they consume more rice and liquor? Recently, the Kerala State Beverages Committee, they have given a wonderful report. It is a report of pride, not of pain. They showed the previous year, the Onam, when it was celebrated, our income was very much less. Now we are more. Each and every day, he has reported that he is earning 34.13 crores per day, which is 49% more than the previous Onam. He has also reported that the 10-day Onam celebration, it has created 160 crores of valuable income, which he is expecting to be 200 crores more. This is a report of fame or shame. Is it a report of pride or guilt? So this is what we have to understand. We should make them to feel the sense of shame, whether they are transforming or not, that is different. To say this to a community, that more people are yet to drink and more people are yet to spoil themselves and the family, with a sense of pride in a public newspaper announcing it as if it is an achievement agenda, is a clear insult of democracy and public opinion. You should be protested first. How can we are doing this thing? So talking about alcoholism is voice of God. It is a welfare act for the public. It is establishment of truth and justice. So we are having two supports. One is invisible support and second is the inner support. Invisible support is from God and inner support is from each and every member of the society, including the drunkards. You have to invoke that inner sleeping conscience and see that it is done. To get the invisible support, we have prayer. To get the inner support to people, we get propagation. With these two tools, I wish to all the members that we will achieve this thing and create a role model. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.